Hello students, welcome to the 11th lecture on the topic sequence and series, and we were mainly discussing about the Taylor and Maclaurin series. So we will now start the topic called as Taylor polynomial. We have already done one questions on the Taylor series. So now we will do Taylor polynomial of order n. So we call Taylor polynomial is, suppose like you have f a function, I'll write it down, let f be a function with derivatives of order. Suppose that you have a function of derivatives of order up to till n in some open interval containing a as an interior point, the Taylor polynomial of order, then we define the Taylor polynomial of order n generated by fx at point A is polynomial of the form. So this is your Taylor polynomial. So you already know what is the Taylor series. So now if you cut this Taylor series to a finite term up to till n, then this polynomial is called as Taylor polynomial of order n. Like if I say you write down the Taylor polynomial of order 0, so you will consider up to this term only. Of order 1, if I ask you write down the Taylor polynomial of order 1, then you will write up to this term. Taylor polynomial of order 2, you will write up to this term. So this is the definition of Taylor polynomial of any order n. So let us do a question related to the Taylor polynomial. So the first question for Taylor polynomial is, firstly you need to find the Taylor series of f of x is equal to e to the power x at a is equal to 0. That means that this is a Maclaurin series. You have already seen that the Maclaurin series is a particular case of Taylor series where A is 0. Okay, so you need to do this first. Second, find Taylor polynomial of order 0, 1, 2 and 3. Okay, now the last is find interval of convergence for this Maclaurin, I'll write it as M series. Okay, so let's start with the A part, that is we need to find the Taylor series for this function at A is equal to 0. That means that we want to find out the Maclaurin series. So you already know that if we expand by Maclaurin series, we will have f0, I am writing f dash 0 x plus f double dash 0 x square by 2 factorial plus fn0 xn and so on. So now your f of x is e ki power x, e to the power x, then you can find out f0 is e to the power 0, which is equal to 1. And f dash 0 is again e to the power x. So f dash of 0 will be also equal to 1. And f double dash is also e to the power x. So f double dash 0 is also equal to 1. Now if you put all these values in this, what will you find? So I am putting it over here. like my fx will be equal to 1 plus x square by 2 factorial plus x cube by 3 factorial and so on. So this is the answer of your first part, which says that find the Maclaurin series of e to the power x at a is equal to 0. Now let us see how to write the Taylor polynomial of order 0, 1, 2 and 3. So you already know that the part B, the Taylor's polynomial, I'll write Taylor polynomials order 0 will be, see, order 0 will be till this 1. So I'll write P naught x will be equal to 1. This represents the Taylor polynomial of order 0. Now of order 1, this will be P1x, which will be equal to 1 plus x. Now third, order 2, P2x, I'll write it as, so this will be, and last order 3, this will be equal to this. Okay, so we have now find out the Taylor polynomials of order 0, 1, 2, 3. Now, I want to give you one important note before finishing this question. That is, the first note is that the Taylor polynomial provides the best approximation. That means that if you consider, I'll write this down, that note, the Taylor polynomial provides the best approximation of their respective order. Now what does this mean? This means that if you consider ax with this, like up to of order 2, like you considered e to the power x with this approximation. Now this polynomial will give you the best approximation for e to the power x. No other polynomial will give more appropriate result than this. This one is the best approximation for e to the power x. Like if you consider only second degree polynomial, so this polynomial will provide the best approximation for e to the power x. Similarly, if you consider 3 degree polynomial, then the Taylor polynomial, that is this, the Taylor polynomial, this polynomial will give the best approximation for e to the power x for the 3 degree polynomial. So I hope this note is clear, that Taylor polynomial provides the best approximation. So we are now also left with the third part, that what values of x will the series, that is the Maclaurin series, converge. We need to find out the interval of convergence. So since this is a power series, you know how to start checking the interval of convergence. You need to first find out the, apply the ratio test. So I'll write applying ratio test. So I have, this is equal to, so you can easily see that your anth term, like if I write down anth term, what will you get? It is, this is 0, this is 1. So I can write this anth term by this. So a n plus 1 will be just x n plus 1 divided by n plus 1 factorial. So I have used it directly, a n plus 1 divided by a n. So now if you find the limit, okay, now you find it to be 0 for, now this is less than 1 for every x. You know that for convergence the value of the limit of this ratio should be less than 1 and it is automatically coming to be 0. You don't have to put any restriction. So for every x, this Maclaurin series converges. So we will write down therefore, or you can say the Taylor series at A is equal to 0. So therefore the Taylor series of fx at A is equal to 0 converges for every x. So now we will see some more problems on the Taylor series, which is a combination of two functions. So first one will be the Taylor series by substitution. So I'll just do example, and with the help of the example only you will able to understand that what does this Taylor series by substitution mean. So if I want to find out the Taylor series, find the Taylor series, of f of x which is equal to cos of 2x at a is equal to 0. Now this is what again the Maclaurin series for because it is asking at a is equal to 0. Now what you can do is that take directly, like find out this is your fx, this is direct method. Like if you direct method, that is if you consider f of x as cos of 2x and then you find out f dash x and then f double dash x and then f triple dash x, and then what do? You find it at 0, because we want to find it at 0 and put the substitute the value in the Maclaurin series, so you will get the Maclaurin series of this cos 2x. So I want to do it by substitution. So I am not discussing this direct method. So let's do it by substitution. So what you can do is that you can make use of the series, that is suppose that you consider the series g of x as cos of x. So now if you find out the Maclaurin series, the Maclaurin series of g of x is, you already know what is the Maclaurin series of this. Okay, so now what you can do is that you can substitute, because your original function is you want to find out the Maclaurin series of this. So what you can do is that in this series replace, like if this is 1, in 1 replace x with 2x. So what will you get? You will get the Maclaurin series of f of x. Therefore f of x will be, so this will be your required solution. So what you have done, you have taken out the Maclaurin series of cos of x, and then what did you do? You substituted 2x in place of x to get the Maclaurin series of this. Now it is important to note that I'll write a note that we can only use this when our function is of the form nx. Like I'll write it down that we can use substitution only by replacing x by nx, and like n is any real number. So if you get this type of, then only you can find out the Taylor series by substitution. Like just you have something like in the place of x you see it is a form of nx, then you will find out the function, the like g of x, and then you will replace like by this. So the substitution works only for those type of series where we have to replace x by n of x. Like if you consider the second example, if I ask you find the Maclaurin series of f of x is equal to 2x. Now you know that e of x, you already know the Maclaurin series of e to the power x. Okay, so now by substitution, therefore m series of e to the power 2x is simply just put substitute 2x in the place of, so this will be your Maclaurin series for this. Now we can also find out Maclaurin series like Taylor series by multiplication. So I'll give the heading Taylor series by multiplication. Okay, so again I'll discuss some question and then you will understand that what do I mean with this. So find m series of f of x is equal to x sine x. So now again you have the usual method, like you find this is your f of x, you find f dash x, then f double dash x, and put a is equal to 0. That could be a bit lengthy. So but we want to find by multiplication. So you already know that what will be the Taylor series for x, it will be x. It is a polynomial x, so it will be the Taylor series of this for x. You can easily see that for x, the Taylor series will be x only, because your f of x is this, and if you put f of 0, then it will become 0, and f dash x will become 1. So this f dash 0 is 1. Obviously f double dash x will be equal to 0, so everything will be 0 after this. So if you expand, you will get the Taylor series of x is x only. And now you also know what is the Taylor series of sine of x. So I'll write down the or I can write Maclaurin series of, like it's at a is equal to 0, so I can call it as Maclaurin series also, because here a is equal to 0 and we are asked m series for this. So the m series for x is x only. So the m series of sine of x is equal to x minus x cubed by 3 factorial plus x to the power by 5 factorial and so on. Okay, so now what will be the total, this I will write it as f1, this is my f2. So what will be the Maclaurin series of this f? This will be the Maclaurin series will be, so since f1 x is x, you have already seen that x for x we have Maclaurin series x, and for sine x we have this one. So I'll write this. So this will be our Maclaurin series for the original function f of x. I'll just discuss next example. So find m series of x square. So again you have the function which is the product of two function, and here also you can write a note that the multiplication of Taylor series can be done only for xn f of x. Like if you have this type, then only you can apply the multiplication of the Taylor series, like this one, Taylor series by multiplication. It can be only applied when you have a function, like you find the Taylor series for this and fx and multiply both, so you will get the total Taylor series. So since I'll write down, since m series of e to the power x is, you already know this, okay, and the m series, this I call it as f1x, and m series of x square is x square, this is my f2x. Now if I multiply f1 and f2, I'll get the m series for f of x, and therefore the m series of f of x is, so this will be your m series for the x square e to the power x. Okay, so now let us do quickly one another question on this multiplication. This is, find m series of f of x which is equal to x cos square x. Okay, now what you can do is that you can write this f of x as, so you can easily see that I can write cos square x in this form. So what I get is, so now you have to find out the Taylor series for this. You already know that the Taylor series for this is x by 2 only, and you need to find out the Taylor series by Taylor series of multiplication, like this. You know already that this will be also x by 2 multiplied by cos of x, and then replace cos x by 2x. So you are doing substitution also and multiplication also. So I'll just write quickly, since m series of cos of x is, so m series of cos 2x is 1 minus, you already know that you need to just replace x by 2x. So this will be and hence m series of x cos 2x is, or you can say x by 2 cos 2x is x by 2 into 1 minus 2x square 2 factorial plus 2x to the power 4 by 4 factorial, and so on. And finally what we will have, x by 2 plus x by 2 into this. This will be the final of the final Maclaurin series for the function f of x. Okay, so now we have done questions on how to find the Taylor series, how to find the Maclaurin series, how we can find the Taylor series by substitution and by multiplication. And so now we are in position to answer two important questions, that for what values of x do the Taylor series converge to its generating function, like it the Taylor series has some generating function, like you have already seen that this was a generating function for this Taylor series. So for what values of x it will converge to its generating function, and how accurately does the functions of the Taylor polynomial approximate the function on a given interval. So we will now look on these two important questions in this section. So let us write the heading, convergence of Taylor and Maclaurin series. So this is mainly the error estimates also. Okay, so for this we need to study about the Taylor formula. So what is this Taylor formula? It is simple. Let's just have a mathematical definition, like if f has derivatives of all orders in an open interval I containing a is one point, so then for each positive integer n and for each positive integer n in I, we have this thing, like f of x is equal to, I'll just tell you what does this mean. See, suppose that you have a function f of x and you want to write down the Taylor series around the interior point, this point A. So now suppose that you took some finite value, that is n, by which you are approximating this fx. Like it was an infinite series, Taylor series was an infinite series. So what have you done? You have approximated it with up to, like you have taken, you have seen that the Taylor polynomial of order 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. Suppose that you have approximated fx by the Taylor polynomial of order n and you have written the remaining portion as an error. So this term represents the error term. Now you can see that this c is unknown. Like this Taylor polynomial is nothing, that you have an infinite series, you wrote till the order n, the Taylor polynomial till order n, and whatever is remaining is considered as an error. And now you can find out the actual error by this formula, but here c is unknown and this c lies between this a and x. A is your point and x is any neighborhood point of this a. So this c is unknown, so it is very difficult to find out the exact error. So what we can do, we can find the bound. So that's the concept come for error estimation bound. But mainly here, what does this Taylor formula gives is that this f of x is nothing but the sum of the Taylor polynomial of order n plus an error term. So I'll write this down, that f of x, so f of x can be written as pnx plus rnx. I'll call it as equation 2, I'll call it as equation 3. Now see, this is pnx is a Taylor polynomial of order n. You have already studied what is the Taylor polynomial of order n. And this rn is the error term or the remainder term. So I'll write it down that pnx is Taylor polynomial of order n and rnx is the error or remainder term of order n. Now you can all from this expression you can see that this remainder term is determined by the value of n plus 1th derivative of f of x at the point c that lies between a and x. From this two expression only it is clear that the remainder term or the error term can be determined by the value of n plus 1th derivative of f at the point c, where c is in between this and this, between a and x. So I am not writing down, I hope this one is clear, that rx depends on the n plus 1th derivative of this f. So now if Now you can write down that if it is, if Rx tends to 0 as n tends to infinity for every x belonging to this interval I, then we say Taylor series generated by f of x at point A converges to f of x. That is to its generating function, converges to f of x, which is its generating function. So you can write that f of x is equal to this. Okay. So we have to show that if this error term goes to 0 as n tends to infinity, then the Taylor series will converge to the generating function. So now there is a problem because this C is unknown. So what we do is that find the bound. So I'll write it down that remainder estimation theorem. So I'll write down the statement. See, for what this statement is given, we have already seen that our Rnx is equal to fn plus 1 this, now and this C is in between this. Now what is the problem is that this C is unknown. So that's why we have this remainder estimation theorem, that to get rid of this problem that we do not know C, then how can we find out that what is our error and how we will show that it goes to 0 as n tends to infinity. Now this is a problem that how to show Rnx tends to 0 as n tends to infinity as C is unknown. So to resolve this problem, this remainder estimation theorem was developed. That what can we do is that we can find the bound for this. Like we will find out the fn plus 1th derivative and we will find its maximum value and replace it with maximum value. So we can find the error bound, and if that goes to 0 as n tends to 0, then this Rn will also go to 0 as n tends to infinity. So to get rid of this problem, we have remainder estimation. I'll write it shortcut remainder estimation theorem. So now let us see the statement. Okay, so it says that if there is a positive constant m such that fn plus 1 t is less than or equal to m for every t lying between x and a inclusive, then the remainder term Rnx in the Taylor formula satisfies, you can write it as Rnx is less than mx minus a n plus 1 factorial. So you can see that you have got rid of this C which was unknown. You were not able to find out, but here it was equality that if you can find the C, you can get the exact error. But what you have done, you have replaced it with the upper bound of this, and then your error term will satisfy this inequality. So now you can easily see, like, if you need an explanation, I write down the explanation that what happens in this. You can already see that according to Taylor formula, what is the Taylor formula? This is this. And where R and X is, you can already see that this is, it was earlier. Okay. So, and if R and X tends to 0, as n tends to infinity, T series, that is your Taylor series, converges to f of x. Now, since c was unknown, you have replaced it with some other like m. So, since you can write then, since c is unknown, what you have done, you have replaced it with the with this thing. So, I'm just writing a quick summary that what are we doing and why it is useful. Now, since you see, you know that limit n tending to infinity, x and n factorial is equal to 0 for every x. So, what will happen to this? This will also go to 0. Therefore, so what we need to do is that the moral is that, so to find R and X or error, we just need to find upper bound of Fn plus 1 X, and R and X will tend to 0 automatically. So I hope this one is clear, that when you substitute this with m, and the limit, as you know already, that this limit goes to 0, so multiplying it with the constant will not change the limit, and it will also go to 0. So Rn will tend to 0 as n tends to infinity. Then we can say that the Taylor series is converging to its generating function when this thing happens, that is, the error term is going to 0 as n tending to infinity. Okay, so now let's do one question. So this is question number 1, approximation. E to the power x is equal to, is used when x is small. Use remainder estimation theorem to estimate error when x is less than 0.1. So here, what is the what is the type of problem? We are given the range of x and we need to find out the bound for the error. So that means that you are given this series expansion for when x is small, and you have to estimate this error when you have used the x in this bound. Okay, so so let's do with the help of this remainder estimation theorem. So for this, first we will find out the Maclaurin series. So the m series of f of x of e to the power x is equal to, okay, now what you have done, you have cut till here, till here. So now I'll write according to T formula, according to Taylor formula, what will be what we will have, we will have p n x plus r n x. So you know what is this? See, this one is my order. If I write the order as like this order, this is my zero order Taylor polynomial. This is my first, like if I consider only this, if I consider this, this is my first order, and if I consider, so I'll write it as this. So my p n means that we have considered till nth order. The expansion is considered till nth order. So here, since we have considered only till this, you can see that we have cut it over here. So what will be the value of n? N will be equal to 2. You can easily see that we have considered till second order Taylor polynomial. So I'll write it out that for this case I have to find out this. Now what is the value of p2x? P2x is 1 plus x square by 2. Now what will be the value of Rnx? Here p2 and r2x is equal to f, like n plus 1 and derivative some function c x minus 0, because here we have a Maclaurin series n plus 1 factorial, that is 2 plus 1 factorial, here n is 2. So now what is the error? I am concerned about this. This is equal to r2x is equal to error is equal to what? f3c by 3 factorial x cube. Okay, now this c is unknown and you know how to get rid of this. So what you will do, you will find an bound. So I'll replace this, the third derivative of this function will be equal to e to the power c x cube 3 factorial. This is my error. Because you have already f of x is e to the power x, so the triple derivative will be also e to the power x, and in place of x I put c. So I don't know c, so I'll place this with the upper bound. So how can we do it? That you already know that exponential is an increasing function. So I'll write it down that now we find upper bound of this. Okay, now you already know that it is an increasing function, and since the value of x is less than this, so the maximum value will be obtained at 0.1, or you can also write it as, since you have the value of c in between 0 to 1, and okay, the question is mod of x is less than 0.1, sorry. So this means that x is in between this to this, and I can write this as e to the power c is less than e to the power x, and x is in between 0 to minus 0 to 0.1 to 0.1. So from this I can write e to the power c is less than e to the power 0.1, which is nearby equal to, or you can visualize that this, that we have to find the upper bound of this since it is an increasing function. So what you can do is that its maximum value will be at 0.1. So you can replace e to the power c with its maximum value, that is e to the power 0.1, which is equal to this. So I can write it that error is equal to rnx or r2x, which is less than 1.11. obviously the value of x is less than this, so this will be its maximum value upon 3 factorial, which is equal to 0.000184. so what you have done, you have found the error approximation. So what is the interpretation of this? This means that if you consider e to the power x with only second order Taylor polynomial, then the error bound will be less than this for x in between the values minus 0.1 to 0.1. So I'll just quickly write down the interpretation. It means when we approximate fx is equal to e to the power x by its Taylor polynomial of order 2, that is, you have already seen That is, if you consider only these terms, that is P2X, and if we take values of X between minus 0.1 to 0.1, I'll write it as this, at the take the values of X between this, then the magnitude of error will be always less than this quantity, like this magnitude. You take only the finite terms, that is the second degree polynomial, to approximate e to the power x, and you took x that are very small, that are in between this. So your error will be always less than this magnitude. So we will do more examples on this error estimation theorem in the next class. Thank you.